Isotope has just released a new version of RX. It's RX 8, and I've been testing it for a week, and I want to show you guys the new features in there. So let's get started. Wait, before we get started, I first want to address a small thing. I've been reading the comments on my latest videos, and people are worried a little bit about sponsored content on this channel. And I have to say that this is not true. What is happening these days is that I'm working a little bit more with manufacturers to make better content for you guys. But I'm not being paid for my opinion, and I'm actually turning down a lot of offers where there is even the slightest bit of manipulation of the content. So just to assure you guys, I'm not taking any money from these companies, and even if I would go into sponsored content, it will never be able to manipulate my opinion. Same goes for RX8, they gave me access to this software early so that I could make better content for you guys. Alright, so if we open RX8, I'm always using the studio version, so that's this one. I'm using that because it's way easier to use, and in Reaper, using the RX8 plugins, it's a mess. So I really prefer to use this version. It still looks the same. We've got our spectrogram, we've got our waveform, or a combination between the two. It didn't change at all. It still has the repair assistant in there, which honestly, I never use. Maybe that's also because I always have a very specific thing that I need to do with something. And because I use RX7 then in the past so much, I already, you know what I want to do in there, and already actually know what the end result is going to be before I'm actually opening it. But yeah, the interface didn't change at all. It has a few new features and a few improved features in there, which I'm going to show. The first new feature is guitar denoise, which I can, you know, show right now, but I cannot demo. But you guys can try it out yourself. It has a trial version, of course. The reason why I cannot show it is because I do not have any licensed music that I can use with the issues in here. I do have some guitar parts from clients, but I'm not sharing any material from my clients, of course. And I asked a very talented guitar player if he could play something bad, and he couldn't. Anyway, you can now get your squeaks and picks on the control, and it has a special noise reduction for amplifiers. Not sure if it makes a lot of difference compared to the old spectral denoise tool. I always use spectral denoise tool if I need to denoise something. I actually always use it on A. So it's the fastest one, it's not the best one, but I've always think that A sounds better than the other ones. I do try it sometimes, and I always found A to sound better. So that's interesting. But yeah, that's the first new thing. I'm not really excited about that. But what I am excited about is spectral recovery, which is this one. And spectral recovery is there to recover sounds above a certain frequency. Now let me show you this, and I need to close this file then. I made a small example for this. I call it Skype sound. What I actually did is I made a very low quality MP3 file, and I've recorded it through the microphone on my MacBook. So it's a pretty bad sound. This is what it sounds. So this is the sound of the microphone inside of a MacBook. What it can do now, if we press learn, it's going to search for that frequency. You can see it over here where it cuts off. And if we now render, so this is just with the normal settings, takes a little while. It's going to try to recover all those sounds. What you can see, and that's also what I found when testing it, it's most of all recovering the S sounds, but you can set that over your vowel and sibilant balance. But yeah, if we... So this is the sound of the microphone inside of a MacBook. It's already a bit better compared to the initial one. So this is the sound of the microphone. But let's do this a bit more. Let's do 100%, a little bit more vowel, like this. All right. So this is the sound of the microphone inside of a MacBook. Well, it's still the MacBook sound, but it's recovering a lot of stuff, which is actually pretty interesting. I mean, so this is the sound of the microphone inside of a MacBook. Compare this to the original one. So this is the sound of the microphone inside of a MacBook. Then this is something that I cannot use. And this, apart from the fact that it's not the best recording, it's at least full range. With a bit of compression, maybe a little bit of noise reduction because there is some noise on the background. Let's just do that. It's so easy in RX. That's like this. Kloof. So we have noise reduction.
So this is the sound of the microphone inside of a MacBook.
We can pretty easily get this to something that we can actually use inside of an audio production. Now, as always with these things, you can never expect 100% recovery. You will always hear, most of all on professional speakers, that something has been done to the sound. But you can improve it a lot compared to the original. Now, another thing that I'm really, really excited about is this new thing. Whoa and Flutter. Now, for the people that do not use real tape machines, you might have seen these features in the plugin that you can actually control it. Flutter is actually the inconsistency of the capstan motor that causes some, well, flutter in the pitch. So the pitch of your song is going up and down pretty quickly. It's on most tape machines, it's on a pretty high oscillation frequency. And Whoa is also a tape machine thing. And I think it's because the tape is never completely stable against the heads. I think Whoa was just a volume thing. Anyway, what I did, you can hear this the best on piano. So I have a piano track, which has some flutter and some Whoa in it, as you can hear. It's actually pretty bad. Let's repair this first part. And I'm repairing the first part because it takes up a lot of time on your computer. Let's just set it to the default setting. Let's render the flutter. And let's listen. The flutter is gone. You can still hear that Whoa. Whoa is always slower. Let's also do the Whoa. Or Wow, or however you want to call it. I mean, this is almost magic. If we now play the whole song. This is not usable, while the first one is usable. So we've just made maybe a very special recording, which is only recorded, we just made it usable. Now, why I'm so excited about this is not because I have tape machines that have a lot of Whoa and Flutter. My tape machines are actually pretty stable, but because it's now in RX, which I'm already using. And the only alternative thing, as far as I knew, was Capstan from Celemony, the same guys that make Melodyne. That product sells for 3,790 euros. So, it's very cool that it's now in RX. Most of all because RX is the thing that I actually use to do these type of things. Now, another thing which is not new, it was already in RX7, but it's improved right now, is the music rebalance. Now, what I've learned also from my last review, but also through the time that I was using RX7, is that this is really a rebalancing feature. It's not there to isolate certain stems out of your music. And it separates them into four different stems. So you have vocal, you have bass, you have percussion, and you have everything that is not vocal, bass, or percussion. And the cool thing about this is sometimes I get a mix from a client and it just needs 1 or 2 decibels of something extra, or it needs something a little bit lower. And it's perfect to use this then. Most of it can be fixed on the client side. If it can be fixed on the client side or if it can be fixed in the mix, don't use this. Of course, don't use this. I mean, you're always compromising when using something like this. Wish I could say I was finally over you, but that's not the truth. Everyone always keep falling in love again. More vocal? No problem. It's live computing now. What's wrong with them? I don't understand. More bass, maybe more bass, that's a good one. There you go. And I'm clipping. More percussion, maybe a bit less vocal. Yeah, it's pretty heavy on the CPU. It's super interesting, but it's not for separation. And I think separation will always give us a little bit of this, yeah, what is it? Grainy sound. It's just not. If I had an option to be someone. I mean, let's try to render just the vocal on best. Now you guys might understand what I mean. So here it is. Just did a small part because it takes a lot of CPU time. There's always something on it. Honestly, this is one of the best separations I've heard so far, but when there should be two of us. And yeah, I know we both wanted different things, but letting go. But it's not as if you are soloing the track with the effects on it. That's just not, I don't think it's ever going to happen. I think this is really as far as we can get. The next thing that's in there is something that I just found out about, and that's a super simple batch processor, which is, well, for the projects that I'm sometimes doing, it's really welcome. So normally a computer is constantly asking you, like, what can I do for you? Which consumes all of my time, and then sometimes it's processing for 2 minutes and then I have to wait and then I'm coming. I rather bundle all those tasks together, and then when I'm drinking coffee, the computer is still working, it's doing all the stuff for me, and when I'm back, it's done. And this ties in a bit with the loudness control, which is a new thing in iZotope. I don't think I'm going to use it a lot, but for people in broadcasting, it's really nice to have. I've seen some broadcasting standards that are, you know, a bit difficult to implement, and now you can just, you know, say to iZotope, I need this to be at a true peak of 2. I need a loudness of, minus 24 sometimes. Let's say minus 25, short time loudness and a tolerance of this. Render. And it's just doing that for you. You do not even have to think about it anymore. Now the file is compatible for the network that you have to send your file to. It's really that simple. And I think that just this feature alone will increase the value of RX a lot for broadcasting facilities. Because what I've learned from broadcasting facilities is that they're not really working on the audio. The audio is always a bit of a pain in the ass for them. Most of all with these loudness standards. It's, you know, the specifications that most networks are asking is for people that are not in the audio, very difficult to comply with. And with something like this, it's just you type it in, press render, and it's okay. Of course, it's adjusting your file to the specification of the network, and if you understand the specification, you can maybe get creative and do more with it. But in general, if you otherwise get rejected, this is a very nice thing to have. And that was actually everything that was on my list for the new RX8. Now, am I going to use RX8 or am I going to stick with RX7? Well, I'm not sure. RX7 works perfect for me. I really like the Woe and Flutter feature, and I do see some use cases for the spectral recovery thing. But then again, I was already pretty impressed and satisfied with the RX7 bundle. So I am not sure yet, and it's also up to you to decide. If you're not running RX yet, well, it's literally my second editor in Reaper. Let me show you this to prove. Let me start up Reaper. It's literally when I have an audio file, I right click on it, I can open it in Melodyne or RX7. So it's my favorite editor to do all audio related repair in. However, if you are already running RX7, it's up to you to decide if you use the features that have been upgraded or added a lot. If so, go for it. And if not, maybe sticking with RX7 is not a bad idea. And that's it for this video. That's all I wanted to tell about the new RX8 bundle. I'll link to iZotope in the description down below so you guys can check it out yourself. Now, huge thanks to the guys from iZotope for giving me access to RX8 a bit earlier so that I can review it for you guys. I highly appreciate these things. So Dave in particular, thanks a lot for helping me. And that's it for this video. So if you like my videos and like to support me, then that's possible by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign, which I'm going to link over here. Another way to support me is by watching more of my videos, so I'll link one of them over here. Now, don't forget to subscribe, keep pushing, and bye-bye.